Des yeux qui font baisser les miens, un rire qui se perd sur sa bouche.
Hi, I'm Miss Glaze, and this is my friend Say from the very popular blog in Paris, Chez Tse. And we are here to show you how to make puff pastry or pâte feuilletage en français, bien sûr. I can't say that word. And we've known each other for a long time now. We studied together at the Cordon Bleu.
Yep.
And after we worked at Guy Savoy together, she was the first fabulous female intern, and I followed in her footsteps soon after. We're both meat girls, but we're here to show you how to do puff pastry today.
Woo!
Okay, so first of all, we're going to start with the détrempe.
Détrempe, ouais. And puff pastry is not as hard as everybody would have you believe. There are just a few simple steps that you want to follow to make sure that your puff pastry turns out into light, fabulous, wonderful, flaky stuff.
Really? Okay, so water, in we go, and butter as well.
And it's just normal unsalted butter that you would get in the grocery store. We're going to be making two different dishes today. One is the chausson au pain, which is actually just a French term for apple turnovers. They're so good. And Amy's going to be making...
Oh, I don't know. I'm doing something with apricots today. We're just going to make some puff pastry, put some beautiful apricots on it, and bake it. I'm just mixing my détrempe a little bit with my hands just to form a nice ball. Okay, there we have our détrempe, and
it's détrempe.
It's détrempe. We're going to split this in half. She's going to use half for the chausson de pain, and I'm going to use half for the quelque chose avec apricot.
Okay, let's go.
So before I split the détrempe, I would like to tell you about bursac. Bursac is commonly known as dry butter, and it's very difficult to get a hold of in America, which is why we're going to use just regular butter today. But bursac has a very low moisture content and very high fat content, around 85% fat. And it makes it easier to roll out because it doesn't melt as quickly. So when you're looking for butter in the supermarket in America, if you can't find bursac, you should probably go and poke your fingers in the butter. And the hardest one is the one that you should use. Plougra might be a nice substitute if you can get it.
So the next thing you want to do, and we differ on this, but either way is okay. You want, technically speaking, you want your détrempe, or the softness of your détrempe, to be similar to the consistency, try and say that 10 times fast, of your butter.
But you don't want your butter so melted that as you're doing your pastry turns, which you'll see in a second, as you're doing your pastry turns, that it melts into the dough.
So Amy's going to do hers hard, I'm going to do mine soft, and you'll see what the
result is. I like it hard.
Right, and I like it soft. So one of the things that we learned from one of our favorite chefs in Le Cordon Bleu is to put your dough on the table like this. And what you're going to do is, okay, you want to flour your surfaces, of course, thank you very much, dear. You're going to want to take your rolling pin and form kind of like a cross. So you're going to leave a mound in the middle, and you're going to just roll out the front, the back, and the two sides. So you have what kind of looks like a little cross. Pastry shop where I did my internship, we were usually making quantities about 25 to 50 kilos per batch. So this is just a little tiny batch compared to some of the stuff that we were making at the pastry shop.
And where was this pastry shop?
Oh, this little tiny place called Pierre Hermé. Nobody's ever heard of it.
Man. French.
And one of the things you want to make sure is that when you put your butter together, you want it to have a nice cube shape, and you want the edges to be all fairly straight, because when you bring in the flaps of your dough, you want to make sure that it's completely closed in. So now we are, as Amy is showing you, going to bring in the flaps of the dough.
It's like a little envelope here.
And then you want to make sure these little corners, Amy's done this perfectly, is completely tucked in. And there you have your little burr package.
Alrighty. Now we're going to do the...
Yes.
Okay.
Now we do the cross.
Okay.
Sorry. You go ahead.
We're just going to make a cross here. going across like that, and it's just going to smush down the butter a little bit and make it easier to roll out.
Your hope. There's a lot of hoping going on right now.
It's hot in here.
And it's not just us.
It's hot. So great. I'm going to start rolling out my butter. I'm actually going to give mine a few little whacks.
This just helps tack down the butter and incorporate it a little bit more with the détrempe.
I have rolled it out. The butter's a little softer than we would like it to be today because it's really, really hot out here. But I'm going to do my first turn. We're going to do a series of six of these. And it's basically a way of layering the butter flour, butter flour, butter flour, so when it melts, it rises. And you're going to fold it. We're going to do simple turns. So, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Simple turns? Okay, so we're going to do, there's two different types of turns. We're going to do simple ones. So we're going to fold this in thirds, basically, just like this. And then I'm going to turn it towards me like a book. Before I do that, though, I want to add a little more pastry flour to my papier cuisson. And now I'm going to roll it out the exact same way, okay? But look, it's a book, but I'm going to roll it out this way. Sometimes when I roll it out, I like to start with the ends and then go to the from the middle out. And we're going to fold that one more time in thirds. And I'm going to put this in the refrigerator and let it rest for about 10 minutes while we move on to working with our fruit.
Okay, got turn number three down. Amy's going to start on her fourth turn.
See, we kind of have different methods. She likes to do the cross. I like to just tap down at the edges and then roll out from the middle. So definitely, you know, there's 100 different ways to stack packs. Alrighty, so I am done with my fourth turn. I'm going to fold this in thirds again and let it rest in the refrigerator for another 10 minutes. We're back after 10 minutes. Say is just chopping up the apples here for her chasson de pomme. She's just chopping them up into half-inch cubes. And while she's doing that, I'm going to roll out our puff pastry. So this will be the fifth and the sixth turn that we've done so far today. We have a little cutter here. She's going to use this for the chasson de pomme. And, I could cut mine in any shape I wanted to, but I think I'm going to use this just to make it a little easier. My dessert's going to be very, very simple. I'm just taking some apricot jam. Not quite glaçage, as we say in pastry, but it'll do. And I'm simply going to brush a little bit onto my pastry dough. And then I'm going to put my fresh apricots on top and maybe put a little bit more on the top when I'm finished so it has a little bit of a shine for magpie feel. But this is very fresh. It's very fruit focused.
And what I'm doing is I am taking my chasson de pomme circles and I'm just rolling them out in the middle. I don't want to roll out the edges because I really want those to puff out, but the middle, I just want to make them into oblong shapes. Sina, aren't you glad I wore that?
Phew. So I finished up a few different designs here. We're just going to see what looks the prettiest. This one's a little bit of an experiment. Just puff pastry with some fresh fruit. That's it. I'm going to bake this for about 10 minutes and then take a look at it.
Just a small heaping teaspoon. And place it on one side of the pâte feuilletage. Then with your fingers, you're just going to kind of group it together. Then using a pastry brush, just full of apricot jam, just want to lightly brush just a little bit of water on the inside. Remember, try not to get it around the edges. And fold this baby over. And it's really important to get a firm seal because if you don't, your feuilletage is going to pop open in the oven.
Des yeux qui font baisser les miens, un rire qui se perd.